This is Max Headspace 9mm, and Trump is going to win. I'm absolutely certain of it, and I have been for months. I'm going to tell you how I know this, and it doesn't have anything to do with polls. It doesn't have anything to do with how many signs I see on bumpers and in people's yards. It has to do with history repeating itself and patterns that I see in presidential elections all throughout my lifetime. I know a lot of people who are liberals who are very, very much against Trump. They talk on and on about how much they hate Trump. And this is partly why I know that he's going to win. Now, here's the thing. This is going to be a bigger victory for Trump than he had against Hillary Clinton in 2016. And here's how I know. Everybody is talking about one candidate here. Trump is basically running unopposed. Biden isn't even showing up. He's not even showing up in people's conversations. Nobody's excited to vote for Biden, okay? But they are excited to vote for Trump, or they're excited to vote against Trump. Now, you could say, well, maybe there's that many people that hate Trump and they're gonna all show up in huge numbers. No, it doesn't happen like that. So let's go back to a recent election that we can all remember, and that's the one of Obama versus Romney. Now, Barack Obama had a pretty loyal following on the left. His numbers weren't that good. I think, if I remember correctly, he was about 47% approval rating right before his second election. And I was kind of thinking it didn't look very good for him at that point, but he got reelected. Now, the reason why he got reelected is mainly because the devil you know is better than the devil you don't know. People knew what they got from Barack Obama. Like him or hate him, basically they were used to him. And Mitt Romney, he just wasn't very exciting at all. He didn't really have a loyal following even on his own side. Republicans were just kind of swallowing hard and voting for him out of obligation, just like they did with John McCain, another very unexciting candidate. The thing about Trump is we have a candidate that is exciting. People are lining up to get in to hear him speak, spending, you know, an entire day standing in line waiting just to listen to him talk in person. Nobody's doing that for Biden. People practically have to beg folks to come and sit and listen to him talk for 20 minutes. And he has nothing exciting to say other than talking about Trump and how bad Trump is. Even Biden's not interested in himself. So the only conversation here is about Trump. Now, here's the other thing about that. Trump is a very polarizing person. Either you love him or you hate him. So here's the scale of emotion, because when people vote, they're making an emotional choice. People vote with their emotions. Don't ever doubt that. Ultimately, people vote with their emotions. You can go out on the stump and you can propose all kinds of programs and promise all kinds of things, but ultimately, at the end of the day, what makes people believe a candidate will do what they say they're going to do is how they emotionally feel about that candidate. Now, you have love here and you have hate over here. People feel something about Trump in between these two extremes. But there's one other thing on this emotional scale that's even further down this way, and that's indifference. Trump winds up somewhere between love and hate. Biden is over here, indifference. Out there with nobody paying any attention to him. Now, that doesn't win elections, and that doesn't get people to show up in large numbers to vote. So I think that you're gonna see Trump win by an even bigger margin than he did last time. And the other thing that people are thinking in the back of their minds about Biden, he's been in politics for 47 years. with basically nothing to show for it. Now, do people really believe, honestly, deep down inside, emotionally in their heart, that after 47 years of getting nothing done but making empty promises, that now, all of a sudden, he's going to be able to accomplish the things that he's promising with his mind crumbling and falling apart, as we can see easily when he tries to put together words and make a compelling argument? No, he's less able now to get things done than he ever was. Biden, I hate to say it, it's not nice, but it's true, you have to admit it. Biden is a three-time loser. He ran for office of the presidency twice before and went down in flames and disgrace, in scandal both times. And I think we're going to see that happen again. And it's sad. I feel bad for the guy, but he signed up for this. That's just the way it is. Now, how does this relate to guns and ammo? Because that's the normal topic people tune into my channel to talk about. Well, we have two very polar opposite viewpoints here relating to guns and ammo. Biden basically wants to take away our Second Amendment rights to have whatever firearms we want. He wants to have Beto O'Rourke as his gun czar to help take away our assault rifles, our scary guns. He wants to limit the Second Amendment rights that we have as much as he possibly can, and he's very open about that. Trump, on the other hand, is pretty pro-Second Amendment, and he's been very verbal about that too. And even though, you know, with the bump stock ban and a few things he's done, I wasn't entirely excited about that. He's been far more Second Amendment supporting than most presidents in my lifetime. And so I have to give him props for that. Now, how does this relate to the ammo shortage? Well, I think there's two things going on here. One is the coronavirus and all the new gun owners we have in this country. There's not enough ammo to go around. The great thing about this is our ranks are increasing. We have a new dawn ahead of us of more people being advocates of the Second Amendment than we had just a year ago. So that's a great thing. That gives us political clout. And as far as the ammo is concerned, after a few months and after the election, things will begin to become a little bit more stable, and I think the ammo manufacturing will catch up with demand, and prices will become more reasonable as ammo becomes more available next spring. But there's one thing I want to warn you about. The thing that happens a lot of times when a president is elected to a second term, Congress tends to flip to the opposite party. We are in grave danger of losing the Senate. And if we do, if both houses of Congress flip to the Democrats, as they did for Barack Obama, Trump will be a lame duck president, which means it is incredibly unlikely that he would get any more Supreme Court justices or very many of the things that he wants to do for the American public accomplished. It would just be a lot of bickering and fighting, and nobody wants to see more of that. So get out and vote. Don't be complacent. Let's elect Trump in a landslide victory, not just an easy win, and let's get out and vote for our representatives in Congress in great numbers so that we still have a majority in the three houses, in the three branches of government, representing our interests and our rights, protecting those rights. Because, you know, what we're doing here is making history. History tends to repeat itself. And as we can look back and we can see these patterns playing out and how they resulted in big changes for not only our gun rights, but our freedom in other areas too, our rights to be able to say what we feel. Freedom of speech is being threatened right now. You know it is. You see it every day. So get out and vote. Make sure that this election sends a clear message to our representatives in Congress and in the presidency that the Democrats are becoming way too radical and we don't go along with their agenda. This is Max Headspace 9mm. Have a good one.